Little Red Wagon is a big hit for country artist Miranda Lambert and was written by Audra May and Joe Ginsberg. The song's a lot of fun on the guitar, but it's deceptively hard. Have no fear, we're going to teach an easy version that you'll be able to sing along with that has a capo on the second fret and uses key of E chords. As always, we're going to teach a studio version that's as close as we can make it to that original recording. That version will play without a capo, it's in the key of F sharp, and we'll use mostly bar chords. There's also a lot of subtle, really fast acoustic guitar riffs that are a lot of fun. On the electric guitar, we've got a number of riffs, we're going to have a capo on the second fret, and we've also got a really cool electric guitar solo. In this tutorial, we're going to learn the lead work that gets played on the acoustic guitar for Little Red Wagon. The first and the most extensive section of lead work on the acoustic is the introduction in the first verse. But there's also another section that comes in after the second chorus and then a little riff in verse 3 that we're going to learn. So let's do it in that order. We're going to start with the introduction to the song. The picking for these intro riffs is very fast. I would consider this on the advanced side of things that we learn on the site. I'm going to demonstrate the first couple here, and then we'll learn them nice and slow. So the first one looks like this. All right, so this first thing we're going to do is get our ring finger. This is all on the G string. And we're going to slide up from 4 to 6, and we're really picking triplets. 1 triplet, 2 triplet, 3 triplet, 4 triplet, 1 triplet, 2 triplet. Down, down. You hear that muted sound? That's just me lifting my fingers up just a little bit so they're not touching the fret. Down, down. Up, up, mute, mute. Down, mute. Up, up, mute, mute. This tutorial is going to teach an easier version of Little Red Wagon. Some of the rhythms still make it a little bit harder, but we are able to make the chords a lot easier by putting a capo on the second fret, and we can take out all the lead work. So let's start by getting our fingers on the chords that we're going to need. We're going to start with this E major chord, open low E, second fret of A above the capo, second fret of D, first fret of G, open B, open high E. We have a standard D chord. Then we have this A2. A2 is open A string, 2nd fret of D, 2nd fret of G, open B. Alright, this tutorial is going to cover all the lead guitar work except for the guitar solo, which we'll do in the next tutorial. We're going to have a capo on the 2nd fret. There's a lot of different licks and different parts that we're going to go over here, so we're going to go through kind of fast. Easiest way to do it is to be looking at the tabs and the sheet music notation right underneath the video player at sixstringcountry.com. We'll go right in order that it's laid out in the tabs. So the first thing we need to talk about is the intro. We start with a little slide. Actually starts the whole song. So like I said, capo on the 2nd fret, we're going to do an open E string. Then we'll pick it up with our middle finger about the 2nd fret above the key. To kind of copy his sound, you'll want the mix to be kind of high, but you'll want the feedback to be to where it just returns one sound. So you just strike it once and you only get it back one time. And I think we had it on an eighth note triplet. So I'll play through the solo now, nice and slow, but in tempo. Then we'll go through it note by note, and then we'll play it at full speed along with the metronome. As always, this solo is fully tabbed out beneath the video player at sixstringcountry.com.